So this onion has been in the field. This is the third week after transplanting. And a quick point of note is that onions takes 45 days in the nursery. And then after transplanting, it may take 3 or 4 months, depending on the area which you are at. So for mine, I have used drip lines, and I've done a spacing of 7.5 from one crop to the next, so that I can attain medium-sized bulbs. And then onion is a game of numbers, so generally the more you have in the farm, the more you have a likelihood of getting more yield. So if you don't have drips, you can use the furrow irrigation or overhead. The problem with overhead is that you get a lot of fungicides. Yani unapata magonjwa mingi za baridi, they come as a result of overhead irrigation. So when you're in the farm, when you crop is in the soil, what you add in terms of fertilizer and in terms of feeding program is heavily, and I mean heavily, put on the soil test results. So before you transplant, it's always good to conduct a soil test so that you can know exactly what your soil does not have, so that you can add it, or because it's easier, it's cheaper to have a soil test done before instead of wasting unnecessary money on fertilizers and manure and blah blah blah. If your soil is okay, you have the results. If your soil is not okay, you know what you need to do to correct the soil so that your crop can have optimum food, let me call it food, for it to grow in terms of nutrients and things like that. So after this, throughout the season, your crop will generally tell you if it's sick or not. Your crop can talk to you. So some of those things you learn as you progress. So I really do not know how to explain this, but you can always check out if you see your crop is not healthy. You can always send me a picture and I can tell you what is wrong with your crop and what you need to do to correct it.
Sample? Do you have a sample of an unhealthy crop?
Of course I do. Of course I do. Let me look. Come and see this. See this leaf here? This is a true leaf. This one is this that looks like a string was a leaf from the nursery, and it has to dry off before you get a new leaf. So when you get a new leaf and you notice the tip is drying off, immediately you should spray against what? Cold. I don't know what the name for it. I just know the Kikuyu name. But you spray against it so that your crop is not affected by the weather. Right now it's July and it's very chilly here in Kenya, so we're having that problem. But I've already sprayed mine against it. Then you also need to look out for thrips. Thrips, looking out for them, you look at the middle, at the neck of your crop. If you see some blackish, black things or silvery things, you know that is thrips. And for thrips, you can spray profile. And before you spray profile, you should ensure your shamba is well drenched. You give it enough water. Sababu, most of the mayais of the tree, of the thrips, they are in between the soil. So ukipiga juu, the mature one will dry up, and then the ones that are in the soil just come up. You never control drips, but if you water it first, the mayais will die because of the cold, and then you of the water, and then you spray against drips, and you'll be through with the drips.